Good morning, children. Hope you are okay. Now, previously we have learnt about the difference between locomotive and the steam engine. Okay. So you have. Now today we will be going to learn block 24, rail transport. Now, S2 connecting this. How these railways will connect the places from one to another. Now, I think you must be traveling, you must be knowing more about the tracks. Now, these tracks, how to identify the importance of rail transport in India for carrying goods and people across distances, far distances. It helps us more. Now, places in India are connected by the railways. Now, east Calcutta and Bhubaneswar, south north, south, east and west. That already we have done in third class, right? Now, east Calcutta and Bhubaneswar, south China, south Chennai, north Delhi, west Mumbai, southwest Delhi, north east Guwahati, northwest. This I will explain on the map. Now here, how to identification of the railway line. How you will identify, children? By these lines, okay? By these lines, either like this, like stepwise, or children, you must be saying that no railway tracks, yes or no? So this is what, or like this, one line and then lines, okay? This is for the identification. Now, importance of railway. Why is it so important, children? People can travel long distance, help to carry goods from one place to another, yes. You will get so many things now from other places also. Then, metro or local trains help people to work, shopping, college. Trains can carry many people together. Right? This is what the importance of railways. Right? Now, one minute, I will show you the map like this and then I will explain you again. The wall map, I'll just turn it up little further. I'll go. Okay. Again, I'll explain you in details. Now here, we have hundreds of trains in India that connect cities and towns. Smaller trains cannot connect some villages too. We also have local trains and metro trains transporting people within cities. We need to travel for work, for holidays and many other reasons. We need to send things from one place to another for buying and selling. Trains are less expensive than planes and can carry hundreds of people at the same time across long and short distance. India is very big country, and if we did not have railways to connect places, traveling long distance would be difficult. Children, in this pandemic time, you have known that how it was difficult, yes, without train. It was very difficult to reach the people. Some people, they already walked through so many miles and they have reached, and some they could not. Okay, this is one best example. Now, so train is very important, children, to travel from one place to another. Now, when do you think traveling by train could be difficult? Just now I told you this also, one point.
Now, traveling by train is difficult during floods when the railway tracks are underwater, right? Trains are not connected to many places high in the mountains. Yes, near mountain regions also you can't go. Or across seas or oceans. Trains cannot reach islands like the Andaman and Nicobar Island. Okay? Now, take out your reader, page number 149. Railways in India. The British started the railways in India in 1853. First, it has started in 1853 by British people. They laid railways tracks across the country to connect places. Today, trains in India run mostly on diesel and electricity. Most places in India are connected by trains. Trains help us to move from one city town to another. The metro or local train helps people travel within a city. Many people use trains to go to work, college, or to go shopping. These trains run on electricity and can carry of people together. Trains also help us to carry things from one place to another. In India, use trains to travel because it is cheaper than traveling by aeroplane. You can see this, children. A person who carries luggages. Yes, see these things. Trains also carries goods from one place to another. That already you must have seen.
1 minute, see this boat, children. Okay.
Now, children, this map, world map, I'm keeping on the table and I would like to show you clearly the place. See here. Now, children, here railway lines, you can see these dots. I'll show you. Karnataka here. See, children, this is legend. This is legend. What we have learnt, no, previously, capital city is this is the line, one dash, one dot. State capital, this is the identification of state boundaries. Okay. Now, district headquarters, this color. Then other towns, green color. Distance in kilometers, purple color. That is north south corridor. This is east and west corridor. Now, distance in kilometers here, mountains and hills, that is national highway, okay, with a number. This is all in one which I am showing you. Now, this passes railway. See, this is the sign of railway. Just now I showed you on the board, right? Now, airport. Now, this is railways. Now, railways. Now, airport. This is it. River, lakes and canals, seas, this is sea routes, okay? Now you understood, this is known as legend, it's to identify the places, okay? Now East Calcutta, Bhuvaneswar. Now this is, children, this is North, South, East and West, right? Now, one more thing I want to show you. This is railway line. See, this is railway line. Can you see this railway line, children, here? Okay, Calcutta. This is Calcutta, Chennai, Okay, see these lines, children. Then here, Delhi. See these lines, railway lines. See, railway lines. See, this is very clear also. Here, this is Mumbai. Okay, which it connects from one place to another place. Now, see, this is Kolkata. Where it is Kolkata? Here. See, this is Kolkata. Okay. See, this is Kolkata. Here it is. Okay. Then Delhi. This is north. It is in north. Kolkata is in east. Then this is in north, not Delhi. Where is Delhi? Here, see. This is Delhi, see here. See, these lines are connecting from here to there. Okay? See this line, small, small. See this railway lines. This is all railway lines. It is connecting one place to another. Delhi. That is in north. South, we'll go down south. South. In south, 1 minute. This is Bengaluru, see where it is. Bengaluru. Bengaluru here. Okay. This is also connecting to another thing. Bengaluru. Then Mumbai, whichever map what they are showing, I am showing you children. This is a Maharashtra. See, this is Maharashtra here. Okay, Maharashtra. This is full Maharashtra. This is Telangana. Okay. Chhattisgarh. Okay. Northeast. Jaipur. 1 minute. Northeast. Now this is northeast. Means this will come. See. 1 minute. I'll show you all these things. I'll just move my video so that easily you can find out. Okay. So this is all it connects. Okay. Railways, it connects from one place to another place. Okay. Okay. See, this is Chennai. See here, it is Chennai. Here, how it is connecting? See this one, lines. It is connecting from one place to another. There is so many places, children. Okay, Chennai. Now this is Andaman and Nicobar Island. This is Andaman and Nicobar Island. Okay. And this is Lakshadweep. Lakshadweep, Sri Lanka. This is Indian Ocean. Okay. Bay of Bengal. This is Bay of Bengal. Did you get it, children? You understood? I hope you must have understood. Now, children, I'll make it two videos. This is one first video. Second video, workbook. Open your workbook, page number 41, S2, connecting places, which I showed you, children. Here we will see this map here. They have showed very clearly. Look at the map and list the places in the east, north, south and west that are connected by the lines in your notebook. Here, please see this map here. They have showed very clearly. This one black dot is here. This is New Delhi, Guwahati. See these lines, okay? Hajipur, Guwahati, Gorakhpur, then Allahabad, Kolkata, Bhuvaneshwar, Jabalpur, Sikandrabad. See these dots, black dot. Chennai, Madras, that is. Hubli, Mumbai. Now here, children, small yellow dot is there. That is one railway line. Okay, in this map they have showed like this. So first, children, you do one thing. With pencil you have to write down C. Write down with the pencil, right hand side. First one, North Delhi, Allahabad. Here I showed. Delhi, Allahabad. West, Jaipur, Mumbai. East, Bhuvaneshwar, Jabalpur, Sikandrabad. South, Chennai, Bengaluru, Mysore. Got it here, children? See, this is yellow dot. These are the railway lines which it is connected from one place to another place. Okay? Here, no need for scale here. Here. Now, question 2. Write 3 ways in which trains help the people in India. First point, we can travel long distance. We can carry things from one place to another. Many cities, towns are connected within the cities. We can travel, third point, we can travel by local trains within the city. Okay, children. Children, one time please see. Children, this is one video, one only. It came in one only. Okay? Right.